Hello, my name is Jay Arbolario, and I'm an elementary music teacher here in Los Angeles. Today, we're going to talk about meter. In music, meter is a tool that we use to count the steady beat. We know that a piece of music has a steady beat. Let's try and count the beats of this music. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 70, 71, 60. Whoa, there are a lot of beats. It's easy to get lost, especially when the piece of music is really long. Meter is the structure that we use to count the beats of a piece of music. Sometimes I imagine that a beat is like a parking space. Cars will come and go, but the parking space doesn't change. It stays the same size, and it stays in the same place. In music, the sounds and silence come and go, but the beat doesn't change. But when a parking lot has a lot of parking spaces, it's easy to get lost. A piece of music has a lot of beats too, and it's also easy to lose track. It's easier when the parking spaces are in groups or in rows. That's what the meter does. It puts the steady beat into groups so we can see patterns, and it's easier to count too. Meter also helps us to create rhythms. This can make one piece of music feel different than another. We have a meter for marching, we have meters for dancing, we even have meters that can help us make rhythms that are unique and surprising. In music, the time signature tells us the meter. It's usually in the beginning of the music. Most pieces of music have one meter, so they only have one time signature. The time signature has a top part and a bottom part. Remember those parking spaces? The top number tells us how many parking spaces or beats are in a group. We call this group a measure or a bar. The bottom number tells us the size of the parking space or how long the beat is. This sets the pulse for the steady beat. For instance, if our time signature had a 4 on the top and a car on the bottom, that means that the meter has 4 parking spaces in a group, and each space can fit 1 car. We could put 4 cars in this group. If our time signature had 6 on the top and a bicycle on the bottom, the meter has 6 spaces and each space can fit 1 bicycle. We could put 6 bicycles in this group. But we don't really use cars and bicycles in music. We use music notes. Let's try a music time signature. We'll put a 4 on the top and a music note on the bottom. In music, this is called a quarter note. A quarter is a 1/4, so we put a 4 on the bottom to make it a 1/4. And our meter would be in groups of 4. We call meter of 4 common time, because we use it often. In fact, most songs on the radio have a meter of 4. It's easy to follow and fun to dance to. Here are some songs with some different meters. I'll tell you the time signature, and you try to count it. Next time, we're going to talk about what goes in those beats, notes, and rests. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you later.